There's so much going on. Anyway, we just pray for each other, pray for our country, pray that people's eyes will be open, that they will realize, glory to God, what the season is about. And I began to think about Jesus, and I looked up some descriptions of Jesus. So we're just going to talk a few, and I'm going to get you girls to help me a little bit, because I've got some scriptures that I want you to put up for me. I didn't try to pull them all off and do them individually, because I have several references, because this is an outline that I pulled off. And it talks about the description of Jesus. First of all, it talks about Jesus' attributes. His attributes. Father, in the name of Jesus tonight, Father, I thank you for this opportunity. I thank you for your people, Father God. And Lord, I ask you just to bless us tonight. Hide me behind the cross, Father God. Anoint your word, oh God, and anoint our ears with ear salve. In Jesus' mighty name, glory to God. Jesus' attributes. Hallelujah. When we look at the biblical description of Jesus, hallelujah, the image that we receive is magnificent. The attributes that Jesus has to offer, glory to God, even through the spoken word from the beginning, hallelujah, because John 1:1-4 tells us that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by Him. Without Him was not anything made that was. And the light in Him was life. And the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness. And the darkness comprehended it not. And that just got me when I read that scripture. The first scripture, I said, Lord, the world doesn't comprehend who Jesus is. Hallelujah. They don't comprehend who Jesus is. And I know most of us, because we're home folks, and we know who Jesus is. But I just want to remind us a little bit tonight. And for somebody who might be here tonight that's not been here on a regular basis, glory to God. God was in the beginning. There was no point at which Christ suddenly came into being or began a relationship with God. Jesus is eternal. Jesus was with the Father from the beginning. Glory to God. He was, matter of fact, the Word made flesh, John 1:14. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld His glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. What a wonderful attribute that Jesus has, full of grace and truth. You and I should have the attributes of Jesus. We ought to look like Jesus. We ought to talk like Jesus. Hallelujah. Matter of fact, we do look like Jesus, the human form. Glory to God. Then we ought to act like Him. We ought to talk like Jesus. We ought to say everything like Jesus would say. Glory to God. He was, hallelujah, a man. Hallelujah. He took on humanity. Praise God. He was God the Son, but He took on humanity. Glory to God. Humanity was added to His deity when He became flesh. He's also the image of the invisible God. Colossians 1:15-17. Who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature. For by him were all things created, that are in the heaven and that are in the earth, visible and invisible, whether there be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created by him and for him. Glory to God. And he is before all things, and by him all things consist. And he is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead. And in all things he might have the preeminence. For it pleased the Father that in him should all fullness dwell. Glory to God. He's the image of the invisible God. Another attribute is that he is the mediator between God and man. 1 Timothy 2. Glory to God. 1 Timothy 2. 2nd chapter. Glory to God. And 5. 2 and 5. Now, the end of the commandment is charity out of a pure heart. Let me see if I'm in the right place. 1 Timothy 2 and 5. 2 and 5. That's where my mistake is. Glory to God. Y'all pray for me. For there is one God and one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself a ransom for all to be testified in due time. Oh, glory to God. He's going to be testified in due time. Every knee is going to bow. Every tongue is going to confess, hallelujah, that Jesus is Christ, to the glory of God. Ooh, hallelujah. He's the mediator. There's only one way to approach God. I heard Oprah say there was many ways to God. Well, she needs to go back and read the Word. I was watching the program that day. It's been several years ago. Many paths to God. I thought to myself, you lost, honey. Because there's only one way to Jesus, to God, and that is through the Christ Jesus. Glory to God. There's only one way to approach God, through the Son of Man who gave himself as a ransom for mankind. Another attribute is he is the head over all things. Philippians 2, 9 through 11. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. Wherefore, God also hath highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth. We don't quote all that scripture, do we? And that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Every knee is going to bow. Every tongue will confess. Glory to God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Christ's name is not simply a title. It refers to his position of highest dignity and honor at the Father's right hand. The scripture says he's at the Father's right hand. Glory to God. Now I want to, just for a few minutes, go to a description of Jesus's self-examination. Let's see what Jesus said about his own self. Hallelujah. This is a description of Jesus based on his own self-examination. John 1, 4 through 5 says he is the light of the world. We've already read it to you. From the beginning, God desired to have a personal relationship with man, bringing him out of the darkness of evil, sin, and ignorance. Christ is the only true light. He is the light. Glory to God. He's the light of the world. Praise God. Where Christ is, there can't be any darkness. Hallelujah. One flicker from a candle will light up a whole room. The room can't stay dark if there's one flicker, oh God, of light. Jesus is the light. Glory to God. Oh, hallelujah. When we get to heaven, we won't even need the S-O-S-U-N. Praise God. Because the Son is going to be the light. Hallelujah. He's going to be the light. Glory. Luke 4, 18 through 19. Glory to God. Let me get there. Luke 4, 18 through 19 says he is the anointed one. Oh, glory to God. He is the anointed one. 4, 18 and 19. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He hath sent me to heal the brokenhearted. You see, that's the ministry of the church. That's what we're all about, especially during the Christmas season, when so many people are feeling alone. So many people don't have what they need. They're not worried about opening gifts under a tree. They're worried about eating and paying a utility bill or trying to get by. Glory to God. He sent me to heal the brokenhearted. You see, we're setting up all fat and fancy. But there's people out there that need to hear the message of Jesus, to hear what Jesus is. Glory to God. To preach deliverance to the captives and the recovering of the sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. Glory to God. We got to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. More and more here lately, the Lord has been speaking to me about, we got to get outside these four walls. And we do. I appreciate. We have more ministries going than a lot of churches do. There's some churches that don't have any outside ministries. They wouldn't spend a dime on anybody at Jesse's Place if like Bishop used to say, if it hair-lipped Arkansas. Hallelujah. There are some, I know some churches, they won't help anybody. They don't send nothing else out. Glory to God. But I don't feel like that's what the church is called to do. We're called to go out in the highways and the byways. We're called to bring this light to a dying world. And we can't do that sitting in here looking at each other. We must not forsake the assembly of ourselves, because this is where we come to get charged. But we need to be doing more. Glory to God, more. Hallelujah. I pray that I can do more. I got to get out of some of my shyness and everything about going out to unfamiliar places. But if you don't get out of your comfort zone and stretch yourself, you don't do anything for God. Glory to God. He's the anointed one. Jesus confirmed that he was the Messiah who would bring the long-promised kingdom of God. John 10 and 14 tells us he's the good shepherd. Oh, hallelujah. He's the good shepherd. Praise God. You can read, I am the good shepherd and know my sheep and am known of mine. You see, we know God. We know him. Hallelujah. And he knows his own. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. Jesus has an intimacy and a personal interest in protecting his sheep from all harm. He's told us that many times in his word. Glory to God. He's the good shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. Glory to God. Oh, thank you, Father. He calls himself the bread of life. You can find that in John 6 and 35. Jesus is the essential staple for our lives, providing an everlasting satisfaction. He told the lady at the well, I have this water for you to drink. And if you drink this water, you won't ever thirst again. Glory to God. You see, that's the message we've got to get out. That if you drink of Jesus, eat of his bread, you won't be hungry again. Hallelujah. I'm talking about for spiritual things, and you won't be thirsty. Oh, glory to God. Aren't you thankful? He also calls himself the healer and the forgiver in Luke 5, 22 through 25. And y'all can write these scriptures down and look them up. We won't try to read all the scriptures that I've got pulled in here. You can read them real quick up there. Forgiveness is always associated with God. Jesus has authority to heal broken lives spiritually as well as physically. Oh, hallelujah. See, when we realize this, that Jesus has the ability to heal us physically and spiritually. Glory to God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. He tells us that he's the way, the truth, and the life. That's in John 10 and 9 and 14 and 6. We have access to God the Father. Oh, hallelujah. And it can only come from one who is from the Father. Hallelujah. Jesus tells us, he says, I am the door. Glory to God. And by me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved and shall go in and out and find pasture. Jesus is the door that we've got to go through. The word goes on to say in another place that if you try to climb up any other way, you are a thief and a liar. Glory to God. Oh, hallelujah. He goes on to describe himself as being the resurrection and the life in John 11, 25 through 26. Jesus, the Lord of life, offers eternal life with authority. He holds the keys of death. You'll find that in Revelation, the first chapter, 17 and 18. Glory to God. Oh, yes, praise God. Aren't you thankful today that Jesus is the resurrection and the life? Glory to God. I want to tell you about a description of Jesus that says he's life-altering. Do you know that one encounter with God is life-altering? It's life-altering. Oh, when you meet Jesus, I always tell y'all that I can give you the word, I can preach the word, but until you really meet Jesus, glory to God, that's what it takes, meeting Jesus. Hallelujah. When you get a good dose of Jesus and the way, glory to God, that he moves through your spirit, hallelujah, you won't ever forget it. Oh, thank you, Father. In Mark 10 and 47, he's the son of David. Glory to God. Blind Bartimaeus recognized Jesus. He was blind. But yet, when he was calling on Jesus, everybody told him to shut up, be quiet. But he heard about a man named Jesus. Glory to God. Come over here, Jesus, thou son of David. Hallelujah. He recognized Jesus as David's descendant. The crowds proclaimed Jesus, the designated Messiah and King in Matthew 21, verses 8 and 9. Hallelujah. He's the man of sorrows. In Isaiah 53 and 3, also there's a New Testament reference, Matthew 8, 16 and 17. Our sins and weaknesses were not Jesus's. Jesus came as the Son of God, full of glory, the scripture says. But he took on our sins. He took on our weaknesses. Glory to God. He bore them for us. He went to the cross of Calvary. Hallelujah. It goes on to say that Jesus was sinless and holy in Hebrews 7 and 26. Pull that up for me. 7 and 26. Hebrews 7 and 26. Glory to God. For such an high priest became us, who is holy, harmless, undefiled, separate from sinners, and made higher than the heavens. Do you know that you and I can walk separate from sinners? Just because you have to rub elbows or work with someone who is a sinner doesn't mean that you have to partake of their daily meats. Matter of fact, the scripture tells us not to partake of the daily meats of those who do wrong. Glory to God. Oh, thank you, Father. Jesus was sinless and holy. He came to this world as the Son of God. He lived a sinless and holy life, but yet he experienced every temptation and every pain that you and I can suffer, and probably more than you and I ever thought about suffering. Glory to God. He was sinless and holy. How many knows that Isaiah 9:6 says he's the Prince of Peace? Oh, isn't he the Prince of Peace? Glory to God. Hallelujah. He's the Prince of Peace. Glory to God. He's the Prince of Peace. The prophet speaks of the Messiah who will bring to pass the time of millennial peace. God, Christ's legacy was peace with God and the peace of God. John 14:27. You and I will have peace of God. Here on this earth, we can live in the peace of God, knowing that he's going to take care of our circumstance. When we pray, when we ask God, and we do the best that we can do, hallelujah, we can have the peace of God living with us here on earth. Glory to God. I want to tell you that there is the power and wisdom of God. Pull up 1 Corinthians 1:24. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. But unto them which are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ is the power of God and the wisdom of God. The third part of the triune Godhead, which lives in you and I, is the Holy Ghost. When we receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit, that part of God lives in us, and we can walk in wisdom and power. We do not have to be out in that world and not know which way to go. God will give you a sound mind. The Bible says that those who have their mind stayed on Jesus have a sound mind. Glory to God. Oh, hallelujah. When you don't know what to do, go to the Word of God. Ream the Word of God. Put it in your heart. Put it in your mind. Glory to God. You'll have the power. Paul understood that through Christ, knowledge is the acquisition of truth and wisdom. And it's applied to life. When we read his word, apply the scriptures to our life. You see, this word, these words on this page won't do us any good. It won't do us any good. But when we intake these words and we put them in here, we put them in our heart, and then we apply them, the Lord, hallelujah, gives us the wisdom and knowledge. You see, wisdom is taking what you know and applying it to your situation. That's wisdom. Oh, praise God. And when we, glory to God, walk in his word through the power of God, then he will give us everything we need for every situation. Because how many knows that the gifts of the Spirit are for us? When we receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, the gifts of the Spirit come right along with it. It's joy and peace. That's the fruit of the Spirit. Glory to God. But the gifts of the Spirit are the things, discernment. Glory to God. God will give you discernment. Praise God. He'll give you the power to have the understanding of the situation that we have before us. I know a lot of us have situations that sometimes we don't know what to do. But if you have the Holy Spirit indwelling and you're walking in Christ, glory to God, the gifts of the Spirit will give you discernment. Glory to God. And you know, the fruit of the Spirit is something that we control ourselves. When we walk in the fruit of the Spirit, we will display the attributes of Christ living through us. Don't tell me that you are Christ-like if you don't have his attributes. That's what I said in the first opening statement. We ought to look like Christ and act like Christ. If we claim his name, if we say we're Christ-like, if we say we're Christians, then we should act like a Christian. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. I like this scripture in Job. Job 19, 25 through 27. Because a lot of references made to Job and the way he suffered. We do a lot of suffering in this life. Because the scripture says that we got to be tried as by fire. Hallelujah. Sometimes we're just going to be tried. The rain falls on the just and the unjust. And we're going to go through trials and tribulations here on this earth. And sometimes we're not going to understand, why am I having to go through this? Job was a righteous man. But yet, look what God allowed him to go through. But I like what Job said. And I just got the quivering. Hallelujah. When I read, "For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh I shall see God." Glory to God. "Whom I shall see for myself, and mine eyes shall behold and not another. Through my reins be consumed within me. But ye should say, why persecute him, seeing the root of the matter is found in me?" Glory to God. I'm going farther than I wanted to. Hallelujah. I tell you, I'm overwhelmed at the thought that we will see him for ourselves. Glory to God. We'll see Jesus for ourselves. So during this time, this Christmas time that we celebrate the birth of Jesus, let's remember who Jesus is. And I hope I gave you a pretty good outline tonight of Jesus's attributes and the things about him, what he said about himself, what we know about him through reading of the word tonight. Glory to God. I love Jesus. Praise God. Because, hallelujah, he was willing to go all the way for you and I. Hallelujah. Let's all stand to our feet tonight. We're going to let you go.